upon. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I cry to you all the day long. O Lord, you are good and forgiving, full of mercy to all who call on you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, as we join together this morning, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Word made flesh and splendor of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And mighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, my giver of every gift, pour into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care keep safe what you have nurtured. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I could not talk to you as spiritual people, but as fleshly people, as infants in Christ. I fed you milk, not solid food, because you were unable to take it. Indeed, you are still not able, even now, but you are still of the flesh. While there is jealousy and rivalry among you, are you not of the flesh and walking according to the same manner of man? Whenever someone says, I belong to Paul, and another, I belong to Apollos, are you not merely men? What is Apollos, after all, and what is Paul? Ministers through whom you became believers, just as the Lord assigned each one. I planted Apollos, water, but God caused the growth. Therefore, neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who causes the growth. He who plants and he who waters are one, and each will receive wages in proportion to his labor. For we are God's co-workers. You are God's field, God's building. The word of the Lord. Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Blessed the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. From heaven the Lord looks down, he sees all mankind.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
From his fixed throne he beholds all who dwell on the earth. He who fashioned the heart of each, he who knows all their works. Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield, for in him our hearts rejoice. In his holy name we trust.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Thank you.
proclaim liberty to captives.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. After Jesus left the synagogue, he entered the house of Simon. Simon's mother-in-law was afflicted with a severe fever, and he interceded with him about her. He stood over her, rebuked the fever, and it left her. She got up immediately and waited on them. At sunset, all who had people sick with various diseases brought them to him, and he laid his hands on each of them and cured them. Demons also came out from many, shouting, "You are the Son of God." But he rebuked them and did not allow them to speak, because they knew he was the Christ. At daybreak, Jesus left and went to a deserted place. The crowds went looking for him. When they came to him, they tried to prevent him from leaving them. But he said to them, "To the other towns also I must proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God, because for this purpose I have been sent." And he was preaching in the synagogues of Judea. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Before I begin the homily this morning, I just want to invite us all to take some time during the rest of the course of Mass to lift up our friend Mike Cove, who's down in the hospital right now. Hopefully nothing too major, just a little thing that he has to deal with. But again, I want you to just lift him up in prayer, like anybody who we have in our parish family, whoever ends up in the hospital, asking God's grace and mercy to be upon them. And again, he was doing smiles last night there as I saw him, we gave him the sacrament of the sick. So just invite you to lift him up throughout the rest of Mass. I'll lift up Karen, who's joining us this morning, and just to continue to be able to kind of do what we do, which is pray for one another, especially in our times of need. As we listen to the scriptures this morning, we listen to St. Paul give us this exhortation about the Corinthians, because when the Corinthians were starting out in their faith, one of the things that they came across was they received this gift of the Spirit, but they're still very much attached to worldly things. The worldly things still have their hooks into the Corinthians, and St. Paul is calling them out and saying, "Well, guys, you're not moving towards spiritual maturity, which is ultimately where we need to go here if we're going to live this life of faith that, again, Christ not only called myself and the calls that we hear again in that letter to, but to all of you who we've now given this gift." And it's an important reminder for us because the world has a way of not wanting to let go of us. Whether it's material possessions, temptations to old sins, whatever it may be, there's always a pull upon our hearts trying to drag us back to things that are not of God. But if we ever wish to move towards the spiritual maturity that St. Paul speaks of, we have to make our way away from those things and fill ourselves up with the life of God. Three things are going to help us if we get there. First is always the gift of the Holy Eucharist, which we'll receive in just a few moments' time. The second is devotion to Our Lady. She's one of those, again, intercessors that's able to help move us away from, again, these pulls towards the sin. And finally, prayer. Notice our Lord in the Gospel today, after all of these things that he does, driving out demons, curing the sick, proclaiming the Gospel, the next morning, he disappears. Does he run for the hills? In essence, yes, but not for the reason we would think. Even Jesus himself goes and prays and takes the time to recollect before the Lord. Again, he needs that time before God, his Father, because as he says in John's Gospel, him and the Father are one. And again, as he talks about even further in John's Gospel, that unity that exists between Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, that unity that's existed before all creation, our Lord puts himself into that place even while here on earth. It's a reminder that if he's doing it, we all need to do that. None of us are exempt from it. So, my dear friends, as we go forward, let us ask our Lord to help us to grow in that gift of spiritual maturity, in and through prayer, in and through the Eucharist, and in and through Our Lady's intercession. Trust me, our Lord and Savior, we lift all of our prayers before you this day. That God's people may humbly work together toward their common goal, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christian communities may overcome division, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may give growth to the work of Jesus' disciples, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That quarreling may be overcome by openness and compassion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We may honor and glorify God alone in all that we do. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, especially remembering our friend Michael this morning in Mass and lifting him up in prayer, that all the sick may find healing through God's mercy and grace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may be gathered into the heavenly harvest, we pray to the Lord. Let's remember Beverly and Jerry Lange for prayer and facility. Let us also offer up our own prayers to the Lord in the silence of our own hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, you are abundantly merciful and pour out every grace into our hearts. Help us, Lord, to receive these great gifts, to strengthen us on our journeys of faith, and to make us more faithful disciples, leading the lives that are pleasing to you. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, and for your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for your goodness may receive the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that when it celebrates the mystery, it may accomplish in power. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, his death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, in his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you. As thou hast, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending out your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord. take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. The similar way when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, chalice of salvation, giving thanks you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God. Blessed Joseph, her spouse, for the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours. Forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer one another a sign. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Separated from you.